Good morning, everybody. Welcome to this time of morning prayer on this, the seventh Sunday after Easter, in which we celebrate Ascension, which was, of course, last Thursday, but this is the nearest Sunday to it. So that will be our theme this morning, understanding how the Ascension affects us today. So we've got Kazi in the wings, which I'm always grateful to have. She's been letting you in and will kick you out if you misbehave. But she's asked me not to tell you that she's going to Brighton next weekend with Millie. I hope she has a good time. So she has a life. Isn't that wonderful? So, and we're, of course, looking further into these, beyond these restrictions that we're keeping having put upon us by the authorities, and we're, of course, we're looking to be having services that are without as many restrictions as we have known, and of course are working towards that all the time, frustrated as always by the uncertainty, ambiguity perhaps, of all the news we're hearing at the moment about the Indian virus, the Indian variant, which we all hope we're vaccinated against, at least in part. So June is looking quite interesting, I think, for us in services. So we're going to have hopefully some good things happening there, which we'll let you know about. Today also is Parish Nurse Sunday, which is a great initiative, which today raises our awareness of the extent of parish nursing in this country, and how we, and today we all remember how parish nursing is such a good thing for so many parishes up and down the country. And for those of you who haven't met Kim Cox, she's got something to say just now about parish nursing and something of her role to play in our villages. I'll pass you over to Kim, and after she said what she said, I'd like to just close what she's saying in some prayer. Thank you, Kim.
Thank you, Stephen. Good morning, everyone. Parish Nursing Sunday falls naturally within a significant time for nursing, as nurses all over the world celebrated Wednesday the 12th as International Nurses Day, commemorating the birth of Florence Nightingale. And it was her leadership in nursing that was inspired by her faith in God. Parish nurses are registered nurses working with churches and Christian organisations, helping local people of all faiths, and including those who have none, to gain their optimal health and well-being through education, advice, advocacy, referral, and of course, spiritual care. I am very proud to be your parish nurse, and would ask you all to pray this Parish Nursing Sunday for those in need of our services, and for the resources to continue to develop parish nursing throughout the UK. The pandemic continues to affect all our lives, and our work has increased greatly, working with vulnerable people and the people who are struggling to cope in general in our communities. And my role now is to make that little bit of difference to the lives of our wonderful community. And I thank you all for listening, and I look forward to meeting you all in the near future. Thank you.
Thank you, Kim. Thank you very much. We'll have a chance to meet Kim in our breakout rooms at the end of the service. So in the meantime, I'd just like us to pray just briefly for the parish nursing scheme and for Kim's role in our villages. Loving Father, I thank you for the so many ways that you care for us through those who serve you in the work of caring and of the bringing about of healing. We acknowledge the role of nursing within your kingdom, and we thank you for Kim and all those who work alongside her in parishes up and down the country to make you visible in your healing presence throughout our communities and within our country. We acknowledge your presence in all that we do, in all that we say, and in all that we are. In Christ our Saviour. Amen.
Amen.
Before we start our service, I should just say that I've asked Anna McColl to do our prayers for us. So you'll see Anna pop up later on. Thank you, Anna. Alleluia, Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Alleluia. Almighty God, your Son has opened for us a new and living way into your presence. Give us new hearts and constant wills to worship you in spirit and in truth, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. We come to our confession when we seek to leave behind some of the things that have kind of got in the way of our being near Christ, as Christ wants to be near us. And so in these words, we prepare ourselves for confession. Jesus Christ, risen Master and triumphant Lord, we come to you in sorrow for our sins and confess to you our weakness and our unbelief. We have lived by our own strength and not by the power of your resurrection. In your mercy, forgive us. Lord, hear us and help us. We have lived by the light of our own eyes, as faithless and not believing. In your mercy, forgive us. Lord, hear us and help us. We have lived for this world alone and doubted our home in heaven. In your mercy, forgive us. Lord, hear us and help us. May the God of love and power forgive us and free us from our sins, heal and strengthen us by his Spirit, and raise us to new life in Christ our Lord. Amen. So Kim will now offer our first reading.
This reading is from Acts chapter 1, verses 1 to 11. In the first book, Theophilus, I wrote about all that Jesus did and taught from the beginning until the day when he was taken up to heaven, after giving instructions through the Holy Spirit to the apostles whom he had chosen. After his suffering, he presented himself alive to them by many convincing proofs, appearing to them during 40 days and speaking about the kingdom of God. While staying with them, he ordered them not to leave Jerusalem, but to wait there for the promise of the Father. This, he said, is what you have heard from me. For John baptized with water, but you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit not many days from now. So when they had come together, they asked him, Lord, is this the time when you will restore the kingdom to Israel? He replied, it is not for you to know the times or periods that the Father has set by his own authority. But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, in all Judea and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth. When he had said this, as they were watching, he was lifted up, and a cloud took him out of their sight. While he was going, and they were gazing up toward heaven, suddenly two men in white robes stood by them. They said, Men of Galilee, why do you stand looking up toward heaven? This Jesus, who has been taken up from you into heaven, will come in the same way as you saw him go into heaven.
Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke. Glory to you, O Lord. Then Jesus said to them, These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses, the prophets, and the Psalms must be fulfilled. Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures, and he said to them, Thus it is written that the Messiah is to suffer and to rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance and forgiveness of sins is to be proclaimed in his name to all nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things, and I see I am sending upon you what the Father promised, to stay here in the city until you have been clothed with power from on high. Then he led them out as far as Bethany, and lifting up his hands, he blessed them. While he was blessing them, he withdrew from them and was carried up into heaven. And they worshipped him and returned to Jerusalem with great joy. And they were continually in the temple, blessing God. This is the word of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. May the words of my mouth and the thoughts of all our hearts be now and ever pleasing to you, O Lord, our Redeemer. Amen. So it's been 40 days now since Jesus appeared to his disciples on Easter Day. Since then, we have heard about him appearing through locked doors, disappearing as he broke bread with his disciples, and now, having reached Ascension Day, Jesus is carried up into heaven. What are we to make of all this jetting about in thin air? I'd like to look at what Jesus ascending into heaven means and how it might help us return to a better life after COVID. It's fair to say that we've all had enough of the restrictions and we need to get back to an improved sense of normality. I say improved sense of normality because Ascension Day offers us a new beginning. How so, you ask, when Easter happened so long ago? Jesus's death and his resurrection and his ascension are timeless acts of renewal that invite us to participate with him, so that as we acknowledge our failing, we rise above the cycles of conflict that might trouble us. It is better to rise above conflict than to be victimized by it. And this is it in a nutshell. Jesus does all he can through our acceptance of forgiveness to ensure that we do not fall victim to the injustices of this world. As Paul says to the Romans, if the spirit of him who raised Jesus from the dead dwells in you, he who raised Jesus from the dead dwells in you. And to the Galatians, he says, it is no longer we that live, but Christ who lives in us. How is this even possible? Surely we are stuck with the troubles of this world, and this Jesus stuff that happened so long ago is just pie in the sky. Well, that may be the view of some who have yet to realize the nature of God's love, who so loved the world that he gave his only son, that everyone who believes in him may not perish, but have eternal life. But many are in need, and many have yet to realize the gift of God's saving grace. God's grace is such that however we may suffer the pains of this world, either through illness, poverty, or the injustices brought upon others, brought about by others, we are led to rise above all this. Jesus teaches us to love our enemies, to do good to those who hate us, to bless those who curse us, and pray for those who might abuse us. There is nothing more disarming to the wrong that we do to each other than the love we have to offer. I expect by now you're wondering if I'm going to come up with a painting or a piece of artwork that'll take us further into our understanding of Jesus's redeeming love. So I was looking for a painting of the Ascension, but have settled instead on a resurrection work by Domenikos Theotokolopoulos, which no one could pronounce his name in Spain, where he worked in the 16th century. So they called him El Greco, the Greek. He was in fact born in Crete, but let's not go there. Do we have our painting? There we go. I've lost my notes here. Hang on a minute. How do I get to the main page? All right, can you all see the painting? Yeah. So, there you go. Many had painted the scene of the resurrection before El Greco, but none quite like El Greco. His style of painting was in fact rejected by the authorities as not in keeping with the time, being so unlike all the other paintings. His work appears to us quite modern and seeks to capture three-dimensional animated form, the drama, and something of Jesus's spiritual connection with the world. We see here long drawn out figures finding a connection with Jesus. Some still seek to kill him with swords, you'll see there, while others reach up to him with loving arms. And there in the center of the picture, you'll see a curious figure in a shiny feathered hat. Do you see him just there? Supposed to be a picture of indifference. You can see him there, he just like couldn't care less. He's like, well, all this is going on around him, and he's just slouched on his hand, wearing this curious shiny feathered hat. One of the centurions, I suspect. It takes all sorts to make a world, and Jesus knows us and he loves us all. He sees us calmly as he rises above the suffering and the chaos, the injustices of this world, a world where hatred, greed, and violence continue to pull us down, a world even now that spirals down so easily into a sort of hell. Jesus went there, of course, on the cross. He suffered the worst pain imaginable. He overcame death, and he rose again, as we see here, above the chaos of the world, wanting to take us with him. Now, I'm not saying that he's going to take us up physically away from the world and its troubles, nice though that may be. We live here for now, and if Jesus helps us manage our time and our troubles as best we can. If you have been raised with Christ, Paul says, seek the things that are above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Set your minds on the things that are above, not on things that are on earth. For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. These are some of the mysteries that it will certainly take me all my life to, if I'll ever understand, to at least come near to. So let's assume that, for the sake of our need to grasp the meaning of the risen Christ, that Jesus does actually rise in spiritual being on a daily basis above the chaos of this world. If someone has a better illustration of God's longing to unite us in love and compassion, taking us up in forgiveness so that we might forgive and love each other from the heart, then let me know. The words of Scripture can spell out extraordinary pictures, hard to grasp at times, but their aim is always to lead us to the risen Christ. Jesus had a hard act to follow during his 3 years of ministry. He had to see through the fulfillment of the law of Moses, the prophets, and the Psalms. And he does this through the new covenant, by putting his laws in the minds of the people, by writing them on their hearts. He sends his Holy Spirit upon his people, and he clothes us with power from on high. What an extraordinary image we have here. Some might be thinking of a Superman or Wonder Woman scenario, where an individual is given a spirit of extraterrestrial strength, clothed maybe in a tight-fitting suit, long flowing capes, and perhaps underpants on the outside. But no, this is no individual undertaking. Jesus sends his Holy Spirit on many people, and he clothes whole communities of people, even today, with power from on high. We are not alone in this resurrection power. We all act together as one body in Christ. I know this is true because I have seen how people have come together during this COVID crisis, not just in our own villages, but nationwide through the rolling out of the vaccine program, our united effort and cooperation in overcoming the virus. In Christ, we shall prevail. Ascension Day is not just a day witnessed by the disciples long ago. It is a time now and always when Jesus calls us away from the suffering of this world to the collective peace of his resurrection. I like to say that Jesus gives us a non-stick coating. Although we live in a world of sin and suffering, we will not be those dirty pans left sitting in the sink. I'd like to leave you with the words that Jesus fulfilled through the prophet Ezekiel when he says, "A new heart will I give you, and put a right spirit within you, and I will remove from your body the heart of stone and give you a heart of flesh. You shall be my people, and I will be your God."
Let us pray to God together. After each prayer, I will say, "Lord, in your mercy," and you can respond, "Hear our prayer." Dear Heavenly Father, we are gathered to worship you, and today we remember how Jesus opened the minds of his followers so that they could understand all that Jesus had fulfilled. And even as he left them, the early Christians were filled with great joy and praised you. Please, Lord, open our minds to the wonderful freedom that we have because of Jesus' sacrifice, and that we are reconciled to you. Help us to continue this spirit of reconciliation in our daily lives. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord Jesus, you showed the disciples that the scriptures said that repentance and forgiveness of sins would be preached in your name to all nations, beginning at Jerusalem. We pray in your holy name that there will be a ceasefire and end to the horrors and violence, the retaliation between Israeli and Palestinian forces. Bless the peacemakers. Please protect and provide for those suffering in the conflict. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. As your disciples waited with hope for the Holy Spirit that you had promised, we thank you, Jesus, for the hope that we can have as COVID-19 infection rates are falling in this country. We pray for those grieving for the lost time with loved ones, for the human cost of the consequences of the virus and the lockdown measures. We pray for wisdom and peace as we are able to meet as restrictions are lifted. Lord, please bless those in places where infection rates are high. Please enable there to be a good allocation of resources to those who desperately need it. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the Parish Nurse Project and for the appointment of Kim Cox to our parishes as Parish Nurse. Please, Lord, guide her by your Holy Spirit and enable her in her role. Please bless those who are in need of the Parish Nurse services. Please provide the resources required for the Parish Nursing throughout the UK and bless this provision of support. In Jesus' name. And I pray that we will indeed act on what we have learned in the pandemic with renewed care for each other. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. At this time between Ascension and Pentecost, we remember the return of Jesus to be with Father God and the joy in the hopeful waiting of Jesus' followers. We pray for those who have recently died. We remember Perdita Swift, whose funeral was on Friday, and ask that you will provide comfort for her family as she trusted in you. We pray for PJ and all the Threlfall family in their loss of Dilly this week. Please bless them and comfort them, Holy God, and we thank you for Dilly's life and love. We pray for all those who are missing loved ones at this time. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Come, Holy Spirit, let your kingdom come. This is the prayer prayed during this season, encouraged by in the Church of England's Thy Kingdom Come prayer movement. It's actually ecumenical, thank you, God. In our hearts, we lift up to you five people that we would love to be touched by your reconciliation and love. And Lord God, we lift all these prayers to you in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
And the collect for this day. Risen, ascended Lord, as we rejoice in your triumph, fill your church on earth with power and compassion, that all who are estranged by sin may find forgiveness and know your peace. To the glory of God the Father. Amen. as our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. And so we come to that time of the peace, when we offer each other a sign. The risen Christ came and stood among his disciples and said, "Peace be with you." And then they were glad when they saw the Lord. Alleluia. The peace of the Lord be always with you, and also with you. So we offer each other a screen sign of the peace. There we go. So we can wave and smile at each other. I look forward to the time when we can do it in person. Peace be with you. So before the conclusion, a reminder that we're all meeting up in our rooms after the hymn at the end of the conclusion. Maybe I'll see you there. May the risen Christ grant us the joys of eternal life. Amen. Thanks be to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
When the music fades, all is stripped away, and I simply come, longing just to bring something that's of worth, that will bless your heart. I'll bring you more than a song, for a song in itself is not what you have required. You search much deeper within, through the way things appear. You're looking into my heart. I'm coming back to the heart of worship, and it's all about you. It's all about you, Jesus. I'm sorry, Lord, for the thing I've made it. When it's all about you, it's all about you, Jesus. King of endless worth, no one could express how much you deserve. Though I'm weak and poor, every single breath. I'll bring you more than a song, for a song in itself is not what you have required. You search much deeper within, through the way things appear. You're looking into my heart. It's all about you, Jesus. I'm sorry, Lord, for the thing I made. When it's all about you, it's all about you, Jesus. I'm coming back to the heart of worship, 'cause it's all about you. It's all about you, Jesus. all about you.
Into my heart, into my heart.